Welcome to part two in a two-part series of creating a new transaction in zipForm Mobile. In this training, I will show you how to easily get contracts signed using both TouchSign directly on an iPad and ZipLogic's digital link via email. When we were last here, our buyers, Alex and Pamela Price, had just put in an offer on a beautiful property. As I meet outside of the home with Alex, he wants to begin signing the paperwork directly on my iPad. Pamela happens to be out of town on business, so we will send her the form to sign using ZipLogic's digital link through her email. Again, an internet connection and a ZipForm Plus account are required to access your files from the mobile platform. I am already signed into my ZipForm Plus account and have landed back on the agent dashboard. To get to Alex and Pamela's offer, I can either tap the Manage Transaction icon or directly tap the address link in my recent activity section. This will launch me to the transaction summary screen for their offer. The last icon on the Power Features launchpad is the Sign button. As I tap the Sign button, I will begin the process of creating a signature packet. I will begin by tapping the Create a New Signature Packet icon. At the top of this page, you see the three-step process meter that will keep track of the signing process. Here, I want to give my signature packet a name. It is a good practice to name your packet with an identifying name like the transaction address or the name of the form to be signed. Since Alex is with me and I want him to sign directly on my iPad, I am going to select TouchSign as my signing service. TouchSign is a free service that comes with ZipForm Mobile. This return folder option is newly added. It allows you to have the completed signature packet be returned to a specific folder. If you have folders as a part of your transaction, you can organize your signature packets accordingly. I will now tap the Select Documents to Include icon to add the form that I want Alex to sign. I will tap the buy-sell agreement and the lead-based paint disclosure forms to include. If I wanted to add a PDF file to the signature packet, I can do so by tapping the green Add External Documents button. That option will browse my computer for the document. Tap the Close button when all forms have been added. For this training, I am only going to use the lead-based paint disclosure form. So to remove the buy-sell agreement, I simply tap the trash can icon to the right. I will tap Next to move to step 2, select parties. Now you may be thinking, I thought she already added those parties in the first training. I did. I added them to the transaction, not to the signature packet. You can add outside people to a signature packet that don't necessarily have to be parties in the transaction. So I tap the Next button. Here I'm going to tap Add Parties button. I will go to the ZipLogic's contacts and select Alex. I will tap Close, and now Alex appears as my signing party. If Pamela were here with Alex, I would have included her as well. I will now tap Next to move to step 3. A legal consent form will appear next. Alex must consent to the terms of use of carrying out an electronic signing. Since we are walking through this process in person using TouchSign, there is no option here to print this legal consent form. When Alex is ready to agree to these terms, I must swipe up to scroll down to the very bottom of the page and have him tap the green I agree button. This will launch to the document where Alex will sign. To the left, you will see the signing palette, where I will tap the sign icon. Alex will be able to either create his own signature or accept a system-generated signature. He wants to create his own signature. So with my stylus, Alex signs directly on the iPad screen. This can also be done with his finger. I will tap Select when Alex is satisfied with his signature. The Move handle will allow me to drag and drop his signature to the appropriate place on the form. The Sizing handle in the lower right corner will allow me to size his signature so that it fits nicely on the line provided. When everything looks good, I will tap the sign button to lock it in. I am now going to tap the date icon to add the date to this form. As with the signature, I am able to drag and drop it to the appropriate location on the form and size it accordingly. I tap the Add Date button when it's in its proper place. Alex now receives a confirmation that he will receive the signed document via email. He taps OK. A touch sign envelope appears as a visual indication that Alex has completed his signing. It is now time to send Pamela the form to sign. Remember, Pamela is out of town on business, so we will use ZipLogic's digital link for her signing service. I will begin by tapping the Create a New Signature Packet icon, just as I had for Alex. The next steps are virtually the same in setting up the signature packet. The name has already been entered because this is the same form that Alex had signed. The difference here is instead of touch sign, we're going to stay with the default of ZipLogic's digital link. I will click to select the document. And then tap Next to move to step 2, select parties. Here, I want to add Pamela as my signing party, so I will tap the Add Parties button to the left, go to ZipLogic's Contacts. Here, I must include Pamela's role for ZipLogic's Digital Ink. Tap to check Pamela's box and tap Close. I want to confirm that I do have the proper time zone. I also have the option of selecting to purchase an added level of security through the SMS authentication option. I am going to tap Next to continue. This next screen identifies the importance for that added level of security and allows you to add the cybersecurity protection. Because this is a training video demo, however, I am going to tap No Thanks to move forward. This launches me to the final step to add my signature tags to this PDF file. As you can see, Alex Price's signature is already present. I will tap the signature icon and drag it to the line beneath Alex. With ZipLogic's Digital Ink, the date stamp tag automatically accompanies the signature tag. This can be moved and sized accordingly. When all signature tags are in their proper place, swipe down to scroll up if needed to get to the top of the screen where the Save button is located. Tap Save, where you will receive a confirmation. Then tap Send in the upper right corner. A system-generated invitation will launch, which will allow you to confirm the title for this email, so Pamela will easily recognize this when she receives it in her inbox. If I want to add additional comments to the email message, I can do so. For now, I will tap Send. At this point, Pamela will receive an email in her inbox, which will have a Sign Documents button for her to tap. Let's now go to Pamela's inbox When Pamela receives this email, she will tap a Sign Documents button into Zip Community, where if she happened to be a signing party that did not have a ZipForm Plus account, she could create a signing account by tapping the Create Account button. Or if she were a party that had a ZipForm Plus account but was currently not actively signed in and needed to sign, she would tap the Sign In button. But since Pamela is awaiting this packet and is actively in her ZipForm Plus account, she will tap the Continue Signing button, which will take her to ZipLogic's digital link to begin signing. Of course, Pamela will be presented with the legal consent document that she must agree to before she is allowed to sign. Unlike TouchSign, however, this legal consent document can be printed. I'm going to tap the Close button. Pamela will accept the legal consent, then tap Next. Because she already had signed other forms, the system recognizes her and requests her password for security purposes. She is now ready to sign. The Let Me Review button will allow her to read through the form before getting to the signing tag. The Go button will send her directly to the signing tag. Pamela taps Go. All she now has to do is tap Sign, and her signature and date will be locked in. When she is done, she simply needs to tap Finish, and ZipLogic's digital link will provide a confirmation screen as well as send her a confirmation email thanking her for completing the signing process. From here, I will get back to the transaction in ZipForm Mobile where I will see the signature packet. I will tap the ZipLogic's Digital Ink envelope and open the file to confirm both signatures have been applied. When done, I will return to the transaction summary screen. That concludes part two of this training on creating a new transaction in ZipForm Mobile. This is another example of how ZipForm Plus is here to make completing your real estate transactions a quick and easy process. Visit ziplogix.com for information and helpful tools like this training video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.